Today we are with Mr. Ojeda in our continuous effort to show FlightCheck users to you and to help you to make a right decision. Of course, to take FlightCheck in your workflow and to make sure that all your files that you want to send over to somebody else will be okay. Take your own control over your files and use FlightCheck. As I said, today we are in Opdam in the Netherlands, talking to Mr. Ojeda in his company to see how he uses FlightCheck in his workflow and in his daily work. Maybe you can tell us what you are, why you are doing it, and how you're doing it.
Yes, I'm Valentine Cheda. I'm working mainly for the entertainment business. I make CD covers, DVD covers, and so on, advertising, displays, all about music. I use Quark because it's a solid piece of equipment, same as FlightCheck. I also work with InDesign, but I prefer Quark. If I make an advertising or advert or a CD cover or a DVD cover, it's very important that the files I produce are correct. I work alone, so if there's a mistake, I'm the only one to blame.
Yeah. So,
I always work in CMYK. I always make my picture files EPS and so on. So before I'm going to design, I have a certain workflow that is very solid. Mm-hmm. From its own.
It's tested. It works.
I don't work with JPEGs or PNG files or something, only with EPS.
That is the upside of working alone, I guess.
Yes.
You can make everything the way you like it, and it's always correct because that's the way you do it.
Exactly. But when I finish with a project and I have to deliver open source files to my customer or to the printing factory, I use FlightCheck.
Do you send out the open file or do you send PDFs?
Both.
Okay.
We send PDF files who are certified, mm-hmm. but also the open source file for
last minute correction.
For last minute correction, or if something terribly go wrong.
That's why I asked, because a lot of people these days say, no, I only send PDF. But then they might get in a lot of trouble, especially when there's a small error or maybe a big error, that maybe a last minute change that comes through.
Yes.
And that gives them a lot of trouble because they didn't send the open file.
Yes.
So that's why we always like to ask to customers like you, what do you send?
Now, for instance, if I make a CD cover or a DVD mm-hmm. cover, it's always a certified PDF and open source. The factory uses only the certified PDF to make the output files. And the open source is just for backup. If I make an advert, then I only send the certified PDF because you can't email open source files. It's too heavy and too big. But for DVD covers or CDs, I always send the open files as well.
Yeah, mainly you created your ground control sets.
Yes.
You did that in the past somewhere. I only need to do it once, so in the background there's always the ground controls.
These are my ground controls.
Okay, so you have
just
a set there.
Just set the things you don't want in a file.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit opposite. I don't want a JPEG. I don't want CT files. I don't want GIFs.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want tritones, quartones, or RGB colors.
Yeah.
Lab. It's very easy to do.
Yeah, it's a one-time thing.
It's a one-time thing.
Yeah,
I can lock it.
Yeah,
like
you can
that.
Lock it with a password if you like. You can send it out to customers who, in your case, you are working alone. But imagine that you are a printer. You made your settings for your company. You can send them out to designers or whoever.
Yes.
They can import it and they can work with the settings that
it's. It's very easy to use, and you don't have to be afraid if you, when you check something, or leave it unchecked, that your file is completely wrong.
Oh,
it's not the case.
No.
Flight Check has control. It's good with the small shortcut Command J. You can collect it. I collect it now.
And that makes sure that all the elements that you used in your document are now collected into one folder.
In one folder, I made a folder on my desktop, which is called FlyCheck.
Okay.
All the FlyCheck files are transported to this map, so I don't have to search anymore. I open.
It's there.
It's there. The fonts, only one font in this time, and images are there.
Great.
Now almost ready to deliver because I want to stuff it. And when that's ready, I'm gonna send it by FTP or WAMNet or whatever.
And basically the only reason that you don't stuff it with FlyCheck is because you have to add the, the PDF to the whole folder.
And this time it's only one document, but if I have an, I'll show you here, if I have a CD cover, I've got not only the booklet, but also the tray and sometimes five CD labels. It's all separated files.
Okay.
So I want to make one package of
it.
One package.
Collect it all and then stuff it later.
That's why I don't stuff it with FlyCheck. But you can do that if you like.
The big importance for you for FlyCheck. What do you gain from checking your files with FlyCheck? Do you find errors? Do you save money? Do you
The errors, I can find some errors. That's mainly of image files that customers are delivering to me. For example, the advert of Metallica, all the little CD covers in are delivered to me. I open them in Photoshop and save them as APS file, but I can overlook one file or something, and FlyCheck is warning me, hey, there's still one RGB or a JPEG file in my document.
And it's good because you are working alone, and that's what we hear a lot of time as an argument from designers. I don't need FlyCheck because I do everything myself.
Yes.
But nobody is, everybody makes mistakes.
Yes.
I mean, that's for sure. And what I always say is, it's like reading the text that you wrote. You will not see the errors that you made.
Yeah.
If somebody else reads that same text, you will always find something. And that is basically what FlyCheck does for you. It checks whatever you are doing.
Yes, I'm a designer and I want to design. I don't want to collect my artwork. It's not my main business.
No.
You have to do it.
Yeah.
So let's do it quick and easy. And FlyCheck never has disappointed me, or I've never seen FlyCheck collect something that was wrong.
So you bought FlyCheck for 500 euros.
Yes.
What does it bring you?
A lot of I save time. I save mistakes, and that's why I save money. And only in the first year, when I bought FlyCheck, my benefits are more than 500.
Return on investment, we call that.
Yes, return on investment, yes.
It was good. It was good enough. You had it back or more.
Even. More.
More, okay. That's good to know.
Because when I collect my job, I can design again very fast. And I don't have to worry about things about that project. It's it's FlyCheck, it's stuffed this away, it's good.
Well, thank you very much for this, for explaining how you use FlyCheck and other Marksware tools in your workflow and in your daily work.
Yes.
As always, we like to thank you with some information and of course the all-time Marksware t-shirt, create, convert, pre-flight and print. That's for you.
Thank you.
And of course, for the people watching, if you have a Marksware product that you want to make a movie about, please tape it, send it over to us, and you get a free t-shirt too. Thank you very much. Everything will be fine. Click the button, get converted. It's easy as pie. You think a long ago makes you wonder why. Now you're ducking, misconverted. Why you stare at the sky?